When you talk about cyber law, though, there's one area of practice like cyber litigation. There's a lot of work that comes out of the IT Act for litigators. And most litigators do not do it. There is also such a situation that there is a lot of work that is coming from litigators is actually not being taken up by the lawyers. Why they do not take it is primarily because there is a lack of awareness amongst lawyers about the profitability of this work. Okay. So a lot of lawyers think that, you know, there are small individuals who have lost some money. What is there in it for me to make money from this? Like, because it is also a new area of law, there is a lot less understanding of how important and how successful one can be simply by doing cyber related cases, IT Act offenses cases, before the chief secretary of IT. You can have a significantly good practice. You can get a lot of various reliefs for your clients from that forum. And even you can practice the same in other spaces in terms of cyber evidence, in terms of digital evidence, in terms of being able to collect critical evidence from online service providers, from ISPs that you can bring into the bear in different kind of civil and criminal cases that may be there with you. So let's talk about that part first. Like, what is the opportunity for cyber litigation in India? I'll give you a few examples. Okay. So there is a lot of problem that women face, harassment and abuse on the cyberspace. And this is a highly ignored area as far as lawyers are concerned, although there is a tremendous amount of work. So some examples I can give is that there is a lot of women who are facing, harassment online, stalking online, their private images or their, what is called revenge pornography, or, there are sometimes breach of privacy by hackers or by people they already know, their friends, their ex-lovers, etc., jilted lovers or ex-boyfriends are breaching their privacy in various ways. There is the entire matter of cyber defamation. Like, most of defamation that ever happens in ever today is happening in the cyberspace. It's not happening in the newspaper. It's happening in the cyberspace. And there are many such situations that individuals as well as businesses are facing. So there are a bunch of cases that individuals are facing, and there are a bunch of scenarios that businesses are facing, both of which can be very lead to a profitable practice if you can make a brand in that space, if you create a methodology to attract that kind of work. Okay. So let's quickly talk about the kind of work that is there for individuals. So one thing I talked about is women facing various kind of harassment and abuse online. The other, and defamation also, individuals are facing different kind of defamation, and there are provisions under the IT Act under which you can go to the IT secretary, the forum under the Information Technology Act. You can approach that forum. It is increasingly common that whenever there's a politics is involved, there are a lot of cases are being filed or police complaints are being filed for sedition for different other offenses. When there is a political debate online or some person is being accused of something, this is a very common situation. That's also becoming a very interesting area of work. A major area of work is cyber fraud. There are entire organizations which is organized crime syndicates working on defrauding people from other states. Interestingly, they never commit the cyber frauds, credit card frauds in the same state. They always do it in another state. Okay, so if the criminal is in Jharkhand or Punjab or whatever, they'll do it in Kerala or Tamil Nadu, in a very far away state, where the police will not be coming to catch them so far away. That is something they count on, because your bank account number, KYC details is exposed to the police, to the victim. But police do not, because there are so many such matters, police refuse to actually act on this. They said, we don't have the resources to go to a different state and catch this criminal. Taking advantage of this, these criminals are having a field day and committing hundreds of frauds every day. Now, if you could find a solution, for example, like using your interstate connection, like, you know, for example, you could approach a, if this happened in Kerala and a Kerala lawyer approaches the lawyer in Punjab from where the fraud was committed, then they can collaborate and file cases within Punjab and action can be taken against the criminals. Police can go and arrest them and money can be recovered. 156.3 CRPC orders can be taken from a magistrate or even from IT's forum, you know, everywhere different actions can be taken and it is not that difficult to recover that money. Many people have done that. And the sum of money is sometimes quite substantial. Situation where 5 lakh, 10 lakh money has been defrauded this way. Some cases 50,000, 1 lakh, whatever. But if you recover some money and if you're doing it at a scale, then there is a good opportunity. Another major practice area that businesses are for businesses relevant. So there is this whole cases going on regarding reviews. So a competitor can malign you by writing false reviews of your business. And it happens. And sometimes, you know, there would be some people who would come and try to arm twist you that if you give me money or some favor, I'll give you a very bad rating. And these ratings are not genuine. And can you collect the evidence and can you get such reviews removed? Because such a review or many such reviews can even ruin a business. Imagine that a lawyer gets, imagine you are a lawyer and you have a listing on Google or wherever, some other site, and there are 50 people who give a fake review about it. It can potentially ruin, like everybody who Googles you sees this terrible review about your firm. It can be very, very bad for your business. So businesses are forced to take such situations very seriously. They have to move to court and they have to file petitions. They have to take the, you know, these companies to task where the such fake reviews are getting posted. And they spare no expenses because, you know, they have to, they're ready to spend substantial money to fight this menace because it is a question of business reputation for them, right? And there are not too many lawyers who are able to advise their clients properly on such matters. So there are many other matters, like I can give some basic examples, like hacking is also increasingly become a serious matter because there are a lot of businesses where, you know, maybe there's a hacking or a phishing and you lose money. You need to even claim insurance. Okay, maybe you have an insurance against this and you're going to claim insurance. Lawyers are called on to ensure that the process is watertight so that the insurance is, the claim is not rejected. Okay, so sometimes hacking amounts are such serious amounts. I have seen, you know, 10 crore rupees got stolen from a payment gateway and lawyers were called on to advise that please tell us, how do we go step by step so that our insurance claim does not get rejected because we can't afford that it should get rejected. So here is our insurance policy. Here is what happened. Please advise us. So lawyers are advising on such matters also. There is a lot of work with related to digital evidence for any matter. Like, so for example, if there's a murder case and I am accused that you have been at the you have committed the murder and there's a charge sheet filed and so time. You have been present here. You committed the murder. And I know that I was not there. I was in a different city maybe. Okay. Or in a different district. How can I prove my innocence? So, you know, my mobile tower, wherever I went or if I had calls. So that data, the triangulation data on mobile towers is available with the, and it's a digital evidence. And there is a way to collect that evidence from under CRPC or if it is a civil matter, then under CPC, there are provisions that I can call for their data from the people who have such data. In. So that all that is also like similarly, digital evidence can be called for. Like if there is evidence in Facebook chats or WhatsApp, it is sometimes WhatsApp is has end-to-end encryption, whatever, but a lot of time the WhatsApp data is uploaded automatically into people's Google document, etc. So it is possible to get that data from this internet service providers. So if you can make a case for it, you can get such evidence to substantiate your case and it can make the difference between winning and losing. So that's briefly the major areas that are arising within cyber litigation. So which is why technology law and cyber law is becoming more and more important to litigators. There will be, in the coming years, there will be immense number of matters in cyber law, and those lawyers who start specializing it, starts getting early success on it, starts making a name for it, starts building a brand for it, stand to benefit tremendously. So if you are wanting to be a litigator in the coming years, you should probably think of cyber litigation and not ignore it as a potentially highly profitable niche of practice. If you are not going to do full-time cyber law, at least part-time is a great idea. Also, there are businesses like banks are hiring, because banks are also getting sued all the time for all this fraud and all of that, and they want lawyers to defend them. And that's also, having an idea of cyber law, even in a consumer case, can be greatly beneficial when you're defending a bank which is accused of negligence, that, you know, you shared my password with some or whatever, you shared my OTP with, it was your mistake, the bank's mistake, that you shared it with some miscreants who stole my money from my account, so you're liable. I would be filing such a case. Then the bank has to defend it, and they need lawyers who can explain to the judge why it is not the responsibility of the bank. So yeah, so that's in brief about litigation.